you for purchasing the BioMove 5000 system. The system consists of the BioMove 5000 device with rechargeable batteries, a connection cable, 5 electrode pouches, and a user manual.
Hi, my name is Ben. Today I'm going to show to you how to use the BioMove 5000 device. Let's start at the back. The back of the device, you see two battery compartments containing rechargeable batteries, which can be easily recharged by a charger supplied with the system. Next to the battery compartments, you find the receptacle for the patient cable. We connect the patient cable by pushing the connector inside the connector and locking by turning it to the right. This way the cable is locked in place. Now I'm going to clean your arm before application of the electrodes with the help of an alcohol pad, which I will gently clean the rest materials which might be available on your arm or residue of creams to make sure that the electrode contact will be optimal. Now I'm going to clean your arm by rubbing the alcohol from your arm and let it evaporate for a minute or so. If you do not have an alcohol pad readily available, you may also use regular water with soap and running tap water to clean the surface of your arm. Now you take the electrode pouch, tear off the top part. There are 4 electrodes in each pouch, special electrodes for BioMove use, where the rear side of each electrode is covered by a layer of pure silver to ensure not only good stimulation of the muscle, but also to make sure that the EMG, the electrical activity of your muscles, is being measured correctly. Now we are going to connect the patient cable to the electrodes by placing the pins inside the receptacles of the electrodes we are going to apply to your arm. The 2 electrodes with the red pins we will place on the outer side of the muscle we are going to stimulate. Remove carefully and gently the electrode from the layer and place it on the right location on your arm. And the second electrode, don't pull by the cable itself because you might destroy the electrodes, and peel it off from the layer and put it on your arm on the correct location. The black pin electrode, which is the reference electrode, we place between the 2 outer electrodes and make sure that it does not touch either one of the electrodes. After we have set the stimulation to the level where we obtain a nice extension of your hand, the device automatically switches into the measuring situation. Now your arm is relaxed and you are being forced to rest with these muscles for at least 12 seconds in order not to fatigue your muscles too much. After the waiting time, the resting time is over, the electrical signal of your muscles, or the rest electrical signal of your muscles, is being shown on the blue LED bar, while at the same time the blue LED starts blinking to indicate that the device is listening to your own muscle activities. The green LEDs indicate the level you will need to reach with your own EMG electrical signal in order to trigger the built-in stimulator. If you try to move your fingers a little bit, you will see on the indicators, the blue LED bar, the electrical activity. Are you trying to move a little bit now? And then you see the increase of the LED bar illumination until you reach the trigger level where it's being taken over the function by the stimulator, while you yourself have to continue during the same time the efforts to move your muscles.
We now recap the process to be done during the training session.
After the stimulation time has lapsed and the resting period is over, you are requested to yourself to put in again new movement efforts indicated by the blue blinking LED and your electrical activity being shown on the blue LED bar. At the same time, the target level is slowly being lowered towards your own abilities to generate sufficient EMG signal, electrical muscle activity signal, until you are able to reach the target level. Now, you are requested to try to kick the ball represented by the blue LEDs into the goal indicated by the green lights. Now try to lift your hand until you are able to trigger the stimulator. Very nice. At this moment the stimulator kicks in and you are going to continue your own muscle movement efforts during the stimulation until the stimulation time is over. Any movement efforts you make during the relaxation time will have no effect whatsoever on the training.
10 minutes into the training session.
Again, the device switched itself automatically into the listening mode, and if you are too tired or your muscles are unable to generate sufficient electrical signal, you will see that the target level continues to be lowered towards the level you are still able to generate yourself. Now try again to move your hand and you reach the trigger level and the whole cycle repeats itself. In addition to the blue LED indicating the stimulation and relaxation period and the listening period to your own muscles, there are two more LEDs. This LED, the yellow LED, indicates when the quality of the electrodes has deteriorated too much to enable sufficient quality measurement of the EMC signal, and the LED turns on continuously. The red LED indicates when the battery has exhausted under the level the device is able to function properly. Turning on of the red light, you have to recharge the batteries with the automatic electronic battery charger. When the batteries are full, it's indicated by turning of the LED on the charger from red to green. After the training session is over, turn off the device and we are going to replace the electrodes inside the zipper bag for the next use. Carefully remove the electrodes from the arm and place them on the layer top side. The rear side is indicated by a pictogram not to place the electrode over here. Disconnect the pins and place the electrodes inside the zipper bag from which you took them originally, and keep the electrodes in a dry place in your room. Do not place them inside your refrigerator or in the direct sunlight.
How to use the BioMove 5000 on your leg?
Like we applied the device to your arm, we are going to apply it to your leg in order to enable you to reteach lifting of your foot, dorsiflexion. We are going to clean your leg with an alcohol pad by gently rubbing it over the area where we are going to apply the electrodes. After we have applied the alcohol, we clean it and dry it. And also here, if you do not have a pad available, you may clean it with water and soap and rinse it with regular water and dry it with a towel. Just make sure you rub the skin firmly. Exact location is sometimes a little bit difficult to find, so you might need to experiment a little bit with the exact location for the electrodes. The two red pins electrodes we are going to apply on the location of the muscle responsible for lifting of your foot, and the third black pin electrodes anywhere between. Just make sure that it doesn't touch either one of the red electrodes. After we have applied the electrodes to your leg, we switch on the device with the knob until we obtain satisfactory stimulation of the muscle responsible for lifting of your foot. Now you can see the electrical activity of your foot indicated on the blue LED bar, and if you try to generate a little bit more electricity, you will reach the trigger level. Move your toes a little bit higher until you reach the stimulation level and your foot is being lifted completely while you yourself continue your efforts in lifting your foot. After the training session is over, switch off the machine and place it in a safe place. Thank you very much for listening to my explanations, and I'm sure that you will be able to apply the device yourself.
Moon River, wider than a mile, I'm crossing you in style someday. You heartbreaker, wherever you're going, I'm going your way. Two drifters off to see the world, there's such a lot of world to see. We're after my huckleberry friend, Moon River, and me. Oh.